Okay, so we have finished putting on all our petals. And like I said, you can put whatever you want in here if you don't have petal beads. But I kind of like the looks of these. I mean, they just hang there. I mean, they're not completely tightened in there. They do move around. So, you know, it's really pretty. And see how it worked with the 6mm rounds? So if you don't have fire polish, use 6mm rounds. Now in this, I want you guys to be exiting out of one of your 6mm like this, not out of a petal bead or anything. Then you're going to work with your, actually I wanted to show you this. In that whole entire tube, there was two petals that did not have a hole anywhere in them. There's no hole in these, so they are absolutely useless. Just so you know, there's two beads that are no good for nothing. Or you can keep them and use them in bead embroidery. Now you're going to pick up 9 15-0s on your needle. So let's see, we've got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You got 9 beads on your needle. You're going to go back into your 6mm, like so. And you're just going to sit these orange beads on top and kind of push them to the front if you can. And then go back through your beads once again. So your petal bead, your 15-0 and your petal bead, and exit through your next 6mm. Pick up 9 beads. And I'm picking up 15-0s, and I'm using the orange colored. And I'm just going to go back and make a circle and go back through that 6mm I'm coming out of to sit these beads on top like that. Okay. Now go through your petal, your 15-0, your petal, and right through to the 6mm. Like that. Pick up 9 beads. 8, 9. And go back through your 6mm, making a circle. Okay. Like that. And sit those ones on top. Okay. So do that all the way around, and I will come back and show you how to finish off your lovely autumn sun. I'll be back. Okay, so now I've completed putting all my 9 15-0s on each one of my 6mm round beads. Now I'm exiting out of the 6mm where I finished off, and I'm just going to drop down and go through the first 5 beads in the 9 beads I put on this particular bead. So I've gone through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're going into the 5th bead. So I am facing, my thread's facing this way. So be very careful you don't twist this around. Okay, now I'm going to work with my red 15-0s. And I need to get this brown one out of here. Now you're going to pick up 3 of your reddish brown or whatever color you're using of your 15-0s. Now right below where this is your brown beads, those 11-0s that you put on in the first round of your embellishment here. You're going to go into the brown bead right between your Superduos. Your 11-0 here, just exit through that. Can you see it? It's right. Make sure you grab the one that's, you know, kind of on a diagonal to where you're exiting out of that 5th bead. And we're snagged. And oh, you're going to work, are you? And pull that down. Okay. Now pick up 3 more of your red 15-0s. And now you're going to go up into the 5th bead, which is the middle bead of your group of 9 on this next 6mm. Like that. Okay, and pull. Now pick up three more. One, two, three. Three more of your red. Drop down and go into the brown bead. The 11-0. It's kind of a trick getting it over the needle over it. So go into that brown one, and you're kind of making a star shape with your red. See how it pulls them down? Pulls your 15-0s down nice in here. Pick up three more. One, two, three. And now you're going to go into the next group of nine, into the middle bead, which is the fifth one. And if you have to be like me, you got to count them. And snag it with your needle, the middle one. Can be a bit tricky. And there we go. Okay. And pull that down. Pick up three more. Drop down and go into the brown bead. So you're just doing like a zigzag. But you're working off your embellishment that you put on like that. And pull that tight. So it gives it that kind of like a star shape. And it's probably really hard for you to see. I'm really sorry, but these autumn colors kind of blend together. Pick up three more. Go into the middle bead of your next group of nine. And pull that down. Like that. Pulling nice and tight. Pick up three more. Go into the brown bead, which is the 11-0 that you put on between your Superduos. Or whatever color you put. Like that. This is going to tighten up your whole entire piece a lot. That's going to make a gorgeous brooch. I can tell you that. So I'm going to try to show you one more time, and then I'm going to go off camera and finish that, and then I'm going to come back and show you how to make your bail. But I am going to cut my thread off because I'm not keeping my bail on, and I don't want to make it with my working thread that I'm using now, because I do want to show you how to glue this on so you have yourself a really nice brooch too, okay? So you're exiting out of your 11-0. Go back, go up into the next group of nine in the middle bead. Always count from one side to the other, it doesn't matter, but go into that fifth bead. And it can be a bit tricky because some 15-0s aren't exactly perfect in uniform shape. Some are a little fatter, some are a little skinnier. And there. Pick up three more. And then exit down into your 11-0 that's between your Superduos. And it's kind of on a diagonal from where you're exiting. As you can clearly see, the brown ones there. So in this pendant or brooch, whatever you want to make it into, you can really see when you're using these particular colors, the orange, the reddish brown, and the green, there's a very slight hint of green. You can see the kind of like the orange and the red. And the back, you can kind of see all the browns. And this is like an orangey red bead that I used here. I think it's called hyacinth. And it really looks very fall colors. Now, if you wanted to make this for Christmas, for a Christmas brooch, which would be gorgeous, I would do it in like red, green, and gold. Maybe white. You can even do it in blue and white and silver. That would look really sharp, the blue, white, and silver. Anyway, I'm going to go finish doing my zigzaggy thing. And when I get done, I'm going to come back and show you how to sew on that bail. And again, I will be tying off my thread. So when you're finished, if you're not going to make this into a pendant, go through some beads and tie off about three or four knots, and we'll be back. Okay, guys, I am done. This is my autumn sun, which is so pretty. I love this. I'm going to show you how to sew on the bail, how I did the bail. let me just grab any one of these. Make sure you're exiting out of one of your 6 millimeters. And only the 6 millimeter. So I'm going to find one that's not going to be so hard for me to get in and out of it with. Pretty tight to get my needle in there. Oh, I really messed that piece of thread showing there. I missed the bead. Oh boy. Okay, let me see if I can push this. There we go. Okay, well, I'm not going to pull this all the way through. Now, I'm going to use my brown 11-0s, which are just my Czech beads here, the brown ones. And first things first, I am going to pick up 5 of these 11-0s. So I've got 5 on my needle. I would be normally, don't look at my tail here, it's just sitting there. You're just gonna go right back through your 6 millimeter and you're gonna make a circle, putting on your 5 beads like so on top. Then you're gonna go back up through the first 3 of those 5 you put on. Uh-huh. Like this. And then you're going to pick up 5 more. Whoops. 4, 5. My needle is like so bent that it's just not working for me. I pick up beads and they just fall right off the end because it's so bent. But I do try and straighten my needle when I'm working with it rather than getting a new one. Okay, so I picked up 5. You're just going to make a circle and go right back through this. And you can reinforce each one of these sections you do. You can just go right through them all again and reinforce it. Sometimes it helps to do that. Okay, so now I'm going to go back up through the next 3 beads. And I'm going to do this till I have 5. Or however long and however big you want to make your bale. I made mine this big. So however big you want to make it. I used 5. 5 of these. So there's 3 or 2. Pick up 5 more. Make a circle. And go back through your 11-0. Go back up into the next 3. Keeping your work tight. Pick up 5. Make a circle. Like that. Going through your top, the bead you're coming out of. Just making, it kind of doesn't look like much here. And now you're going to work your way back up into the next 3 beads. So you're coming out at the top again. Like that. Pulling tight. So we have, whoops. We have, let me see here. We have this one. 1, 2, 3. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So you actually have 6. So you have 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. Okay. Make a circle and go back through. Make another section. Go back up into the first 3 beads. Like this, and one more now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 beads, and make your last section. Kind of got a knot in the middle of my work. There we go. I need to move my needle down because my tail is longer than my working thread. Can't handle that. There we go. Uh-huh. Alright, so now you're going to work your way up again through the first 3 beads. Now we're going to attach this bale . Okay, so this is all supposed to be very nice and tight, so it's nice to reinforce. So now what you're going to do is you're going to pick up 2 beads, 2 of them, and you're going to go right back through that same 6 millimeter bead. Okay. Oh. Wow, I keep getting hooked on this. It's really frustrating. You have no idea. Okay, and pick up 2 more. After you've gone through your 6 millimeter, pick up 2 more. And now you're going to go through. Let me see, did I go the right way here? Yes. So now you're going to go through that. I made a boo-boo. I went through it the wrong way. So this is what you need to do, is really pay attention to your... and I'm never going to get my thread back out of there because there's so many passes in there. I'm guaranteed to snag something in this 6 millimeter. Yeah, the only way I'm going to do that is by taking my needle off. So... I'll be back in a sec. I'll be back. Okay, so now we have to pay attention. This is my back of my pendant. You need to pay attention, don't do what I did, to where your thread is exiting on this very last bead that you went in that group of 5 in the middle bead here. So you make sure you enter your 6 millimeter on the same side you're exiting and not cross over like I did, because that'll end up twisting your bale. So I need to pick up 2 11 O's first and then enter into your 6 millimeter. Somewhere here. Wow, I just don't want to break any of my beads because I don't want to redo this. Goodness sakes. There we go. So, bring this through. Okay. So you've got one side done. Now pick up 2 more of your 11 O's. And now you're going to exit through the middle bead that you were just exiting. Here, you picked up two and went in. You need to go back into this bead here and pull this all nice and tight. All right. Now, you're going to embellish this. All right. I do not know what's going on here. I'll be back. Okay, so another thing to be careful not to do is accidentally put your thread through your loop here before you put it in exit out of this bead here. That's what I did, and somehow my bail got all twisted. So let's go and see if this is going to work. There we go. That's what I want to see. Okay, so now what you're going to do is go back down through these two beads and back through your thing, your 6mm, to reinforce this, a bail, in your 6mm fire polish or bead, and pull that tight. And now your bail should be on there nice and snug. Okay, like that. Now what you're going to do is go up into the first or the last two beads you put on, and only through the two beads, not that middle bead that's connecting your work. Then you're going to pick up 1/11 Delica. So I'm using my green Delicas. And I don't know how I'm going to show you this. Pick it up. You're exiting through these two. You have two beads on each side of your one bead in the middle that's connecting all your groups. Go through the two side beads and place your green, your 11/0 Delica in there, like that. Pick up another one, another Delica, and go through the two side beads. So just the two side beads. Like this, and place your 11/0 Delica there like that. Pick up another 11/0 and just keep doing this, going through the two side beads, and where that gap is, you're going to fill it in. Pick up another one, go through the two side beads. Another 11/0 down through the two side beads, placing that in there. One more, and then go down through the last two of your side beads. That will bring you to your 6mm, and then you're going to run your needle through your 6mm. I think it's starting to get a bit tight for me. It doesn't help that I'm switched over to a size 12, 10 beading needle either. I see what's going on. Okay. So go through your 6mm and go back up the next two beads that you put on that are over top of your crystal. Like that. And now we're going to do the same thing down this side, picking up one Delica and going through the two side beads. So now we have to balance this out. A Delica through the two side beads. And it should look like this. Start taking shape. A Delica through the two side beads. A Delica through the two side beads. And not the middle one. Delica. And two side beads. And one more Delica. And back down into your last two beads. So from this point on now, all you're going to do is go all the way around and just keep reinforcing it till you find it that it's good and strong and you know it's not going to fall apart on you. I'm trying to get that last bead in place there, like that. So I just use these to kind of round it out. See, there's your bail. And it looks really nice with your colors in here. Mine's not tightened up, it's actually loosened up, but it does look better when it's tight, see? And you gotta go and reinforce it. So, as I promised, I am going to make this into a brooch. So all I'm going to do is cut all of this thread and cut all these beads off. Because I don't want another pendant. And I'm just going to... I kind of loosened this up a little bit, probably, because I was working in here. So that's going to happen. We're going to pull that out. Pull these threads out, if we can. There we go. And she's done. There we go. Now, let me get all these beads out of my way here. And here is your brooch pin. And if you've got one like this, you're welcome, like I said, to sew it on. Or you're welcome to glue it on. And I would suggest gluing it on because sewing it on isn't, I don't think it's as secure as we want it to be. Unless you went through this a million times. And with these big holes, I tried sewing these before, and they just make one heck of a mess because you have so much thread back there. So now we want to kind of center this so we don't see our brooch pin, but we've got to get in here. So we got to go between some 6 millimeters. So all you're going to do is take your E6000. Okay, before my camera died, I want to show you quickly before it dies again how to put this on. So make sure that when you put your brooch on, make sure you put the pin on right, and you put it between three of your crystals like this. So I'm just going to stick some glue here. And E6000 is really thick glue, so you don't have to worry about it leaking out. And I really didn't want to do that, but anyway. And then I'm going to stick a little bit on here as well. Get some through the holes here. And there is going to be a lot of glue. And then I'm going to stick it down and press it in there. And now I'm just going to leave it alone. And make sure none of the glue came through, which it didn't. And I'm just going to press it there and hold it for a few seconds. Make sure it's nice and straight, that your pin's going to sit straight. As I can see, this pin isn't all that straight, so I want it to sit straight on me. So I'm just going to hold that down for a brief few minutes. Then I'm going to take the glue and spread it all around here, on the inside here, where it's squeezed out. I'm going to scoop off with this piece of wire, put some glue on it. It's starting to really thicken already. That's really going to secure it. So I'm just going to put a little more glue on this. And I'm going to make sure that this is good and glued and attached to beads so it doesn't come off. And actually, I'm going to let this dry overnight before I even attempt to open it or touch it or move it. I'm just going to let it dry overnight. So smooth this glue out nice and neatly so you don't have big gobs of it. Okay, and I think that's about right. Make sure it's sitting flat. I want to collect the glue out of there too. Don't want any glue coming through my front, and it hasn't. So I'm quite happy about that.
There we go.
It is nicely glued on there, and this will all smooth out. Your brooch pin ain't going anywhere once this glue sets. And I would say a good 24 hours. Let it set. Don't touch it. Don't pick it up. Don't even look at it. Make sure you have a look at it and it's set straight before you put that down for your hours. And push. There we go. So that's it, you guys. There's your pendant. And there's your brooch. And out of camera view. Very good.
I want to be very careful with this.
So there's your pendant. And there's your brooch.
And both done with two different size, or two different sets of 6 millimeters.
So like I said, play with yours. Make it your own. Do what you want with it. Have fun with it, you know. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. I know I made a lot of mistakes, but I'm one of those ones that'll stay on camera and show you my mistakes, because I'm sure they happen to you too. So it's an easy way I show you to fix it. Anyway, I'm going to leave this brooch pin to set. As you can see, it's falling off because I had it upside down. Yeah, so we're good. All right, everyone. I want to show you something quick before my battery dies again, but this is the next project I'm working on, as everybody wanted this really gorgeous, lovely change purse. This change purse is very beautiful, and I put a closure on it. I sewed it on, so here's the pattern. I won't be doing this same pattern, but the pattern I'm designing right now, it's going to be really pretty and done sort of similar to this, but not quite the same. And it does have the flap with the fringe on it. And I just hung a little charm off of it and on the sides. So this is my change purse that I want to show you guys how to make. And here, I'm just showing you this on the camera so you can get a rough idea as to how big it is. I'll zoom out a little bit so you can see it against my hand here. So there's my hand. That's the whole purse opened up. I did use it when I went to Las Vegas. That's the only time I used it. I think it's so precious. Also, I designed these lighter covers, and this is my son's name, and I just never finished it. This goes over a Bic lighter. I don't even remember how I did this. I know it was tubular peyote, and I'll get to finishing that someday, maybe show you guys how to use it if I can remember. I'd have to count every single row in here. But this one here, I will definitely be showing you guys how to make this. Okay, so I'll see you guys all soon. I hope you've enjoyed your tutorial on your autumn sun, and I'll see you soon on the next video. Bye-bye!